Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released iOS 13 Developer Beta 8. This is available to developers and soon to public beta testers. It could be out by the time you're watching this. If it's not, wait a couple hours or the following day is when it normally comes out. So it's available at the same time in all countries on all supported devices. Now this came in at 130.2 megabytes on my iPhone XS Max. It was similarly sized on all the devices you see here, the iPhone SE, the iPad Air 2, the iPhone XR, and the iPhone 6S Plus on my right. Now let's take a look at the build number. The build number is 17A5572A, and with it being A, we're getting much closer to the final build. However, this particular build was created on August 15th. Normally they'll release an update and then they'll have another one ready to go the next few days once they fix some things. And they have a bunch of them internally that they just don't release to the public. So we're trying out one that's newer than the previous one, but does not have a lot of changes in it. And so there are no modem changes. So if you're having issues with Wi-Fi or cellular, there's nothing changed there, no modem updates. And there are 33 known issues that still remain, at least that they're showing on the notes. And then there are 3 resolved issues. And the one resolved issue I wanted to let you know about is iCloud Drive section in settings. So if we go to settings, then we go to general, and then iPhone storage, the actual storage should be represented properly now for your iCloud Drive, your iPhone, and everything else. So all of your storage here, depending on where it's stored, should be accurate now, according to Apple in this particular build. Now, as far as new things, well, there's really only one that I've seen so far, and that's with the clock. When you 3D touch or haptic press on the clock here, you have create an alarm, resume stopwatch, and start timer. If we take a look at it, on the iPhone XR, you'll see it's the same. So haptic touch and 3D touch are working well. But if we look at it in beta 7, it's a little bit different. I have beta 7 on the iPhone 6S Plus here. So you'll see it's missing resume stopwatch and start timer. So there's a couple new things there. And Apple continues to refine all of the different features, and this particular beta feels much faster. In fact, 3D touch is nice and fast with everything, and swiping and everything else feels much, much better. In fact, this is more of a performance refinement, I think, than anything else. Now, 3D touch, people ask me, does peek and pop work? Well, it seems like it's working just fine, although it still doesn't feel like iOS 12 3D touch. Has a little bit different animation to it. So it's much faster though. Everything you're doing within here is much faster. So really nice as far as that goes. Now, as far as app launching, before I talked about where you had to uninstall and reinstall an app to make it launch faster, it seems like they may have fixed this because all these apps feel like they're crazy fast when you open them for the first time. I closed all of these apps, went through, opened a bunch of them, like news there, you'll see how fast everything's loading. Nice and fast. And I can do the same even on the oldest device, the iPhone SE here. If I open up music, that's the first time I've opened music on this. Settings. We'll open weather here. We'll wait for it to load. It'll take just a moment. There we go. So you'll see even on the oldest device, it's going pretty quickly. So that's nice. Now, as far as other little fixes, I've seen quite a few fixes throughout. However, that one bug that everyone really doesn't like, the 3-finger touch and hold, is still there. So if you touch and hold with 3 fingers on your display, you'll still get that cut, copy, paste little dialogue at the top, like we saw in previous betas. So that's there. It will still annoy you. I don't see a way to turn that off just yet. Also, under automation here for shortcuts, that little automation tab is still missing. They do say they're going to bring it back, but it's missing under Siri shortcuts or shortcuts right now. Also, the setting where you can announce Siri incoming messages and things, when you go to your Siri settings, they are not there. So it's missing. I plugged in my AirPods and I wasn't able to get it to pop up. Now, the last beta I wasn't seeing it and someone said they saw it, but currently on all these devices, I'm not seeing that. Also, mail is actually working quite well for me now. Messages are loading properly. After I gave it a few minutes, messages are loading quickly and properly now. And hopefully this fixes it. We don't really know at this point. Also, Instagram and Twitter, where they had the issues with the last line being unable to see text or when you're typing in Instagram, that's all fixed. So they did something with the text and that seems to be working okay. However, those of you using banking apps aren't going to be happy. Under my finance one, I still have apps that are crashing. So you still may have an issue. In fact, most likely someone is going to have to update that app for iOS 13 and get it ready, those particular banks. And then finally, barcodes. If you use anything like Dunkin' Donuts for coffee or any of those, the barcodes were all really blurry. Those seem to be fixed now, so that's really good. Now, as far as iPad OS, it seems to be working well, but I've not seen any changes whatsoever. Everything's fast and fluid. If I rotate it here, you can see we can bring in the little widgets on the side. It's working well, but I'm not seeing anything new specific to iPad OS or iOS. So all of these devices seem to be working fine, but I'm not seeing anything new. Now, as far as battery life, I know a lot of people want to know, how is battery life? Well, it takes a few days to know for sure, but it was okay on the previous version. Not amazing, but okay. You'll see if I go to the last 10 days, 4 hours and 51 minutes of screen on time, about an hour of screen off time. 6.5 hours is about what I was seeing throughout an entire day, and then I would need to charge it. So it can vary depending on what you're doing. And this device has 100% battery health, and that's to just show you the best case scenario. Now, one thing I noticed as far as performance, not only is speed better, but voice to text seems to be much better. So you can see here, it's actually keeping up on the waveforms on the bottom, and it seems to be a little bit more accurate than it was before. Even as I speed up my voice, it seems to keep up. So that's really, really good. And it kept up pretty good overall. You can see if you read this, it's about as accurate as I've seen. So that's a great sign. Now, on the oldest device, the iPhone SE, apps like Minecraft seem to be loading okay, much faster than I think they did before. You'll see that loaded nice and fast. We'll create a new world, hit create, and see how long this takes, because this is zipping right along and seems like it's just working better overall. So you'll see it's loading. And a lot of the time before, I had to wait quite a while, and now it's playable and we're in. That seems much, much faster. And I didn't uninstall and reinstall the app. So everything from Fortnite to PUBG or whatever you play should load faster, assuming that it continues to work and doesn't crash. But overall, it seems to be good. Now, for those of you that want to see the Geekbench scores, of course, I ran those. So let's take a look. So for single core, I have 4,790. Multi-core is 11,370. This is on my iPhone XS Max. If we take a look at the history, you'll see it's very, very similar. Even though it looks like it's a little bit lower, I ran this as soon as I was done installing the beta. So usually these numbers will improve a little bit. But let me set up all these different devices to give you sort of a reference as to what Geekbench should be for all of these. From left to right, I have the iPad Air 2, the iPhone SE, the iPhone 6S Plus. Now keep in mind, the 6S Plus is on the previous beta. So if you're anywhere around these numbers, you should be good. Then the iPhone XR and the iPhone XS Max. So that's it for the Geekbench scores. It seems like iOS 13 is getting more and more refined. Of course, we'll probably see it finally released to the public somewhere in mid-September. We expect an event on the 10th, so it could be that Friday. We're not really sure yet. But until that time in September, we have a couple weeks left, so I would expect to see a couple more betas. iOS 12 actually had 12 betas and then the Gold Master or GM. So we're only at beta 8. We could see multiple in a week. We've seen that before. So it's hard to say right now what the release schedule will be, but we should see quite a few more. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description as I always do. And if you've found anything else or you're having a different experience, let me know in the comments below and I'll be doing a follow-up as well to see how it went for you. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe and hit that notification bell if you'd like to see more of these videos as soon as they're released. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.